Friends, welcome. Welcome. It's so good to see you. These happy faces in these very dark times. As you know, a welcomed hand is needed. Us Jews, we're not able to touch anything unclean and anything dead. And I do fear that by the time we reach the crucifixion site, he will in fact be dead. The Sabbath is quickly approaching, so what we do now, we must do quickly. And I believe I heard thunder or lightning before, so before the rains come upon us, we should go. Come with me. Joseph, shalom.
Shalom. There you are at last. You've come too late.
Too late?
Yes, I've already personally obtained permission from Pontius Pilate for his body. He's ordered some of his people to go and take him down now. Jesus will be laid to rest in my own personal tomb. The body will be wrapped and anointed, according to custom. The attendants are on their way to the tomb now. The women and I will follow shortly.
Oh, surely, Joseph, this has all happened too quickly.
Yes, indeed. Seems not so long ago, he came riding into Jerusalem, the people shouting praise, singing Hosanna in the highest. But now he lies dead, a savior killed by the hands of those he came to save.
No, but Joseph, listen to yourself. We must keep our faith. Did not the scriptures say that he would come and be despised and rejected, even by those who he came to save? Or the prophet Isaiah, he told us that Jesus must die before he can conquer death in the grave. Please, Joseph, brother, have faith.
I know. Truly, I do. But faith seems so far away now. Will you attend to Mary? He was her son. I must leave you now, Nathan, for it is my duty to oversee the sealing of the tomb. Shalom, Nathan.
Shalom, Joseph. Such a shame. A man so amazing to be killed. Shalom, Mary. How are you?
Shalom, Nathan. I'm as well as I can be. My heart is broken, but I have hope. You know, when Jesus was 8 days old, we took him to the temple and we were approached by Simeon. He had waited his whole life to see the Messiah. And when he saw Jesus as a baby, he took him in his arms and he blessed him. I was so overwhelmed. I was a young girl trying to understand all the events that were happening around me and through me. I was so honored and humbled by it all. Even when Simeon said that a sword would pierce my soul, I did not imagine this kind of sorrow. Yet, everything has happened just as Jesus said that it would. And now, we have to leave the rest in God's hands. I must go, Nathan. The others are waiting. Shalom.
Shalom, Mary. Oh, friends, it seems such a waste to bring you this far and for nothing. But perhaps we could continue on to the tomb where they're laying him to rest and pay our own respects. Come with me. Shalom, Rufus.
Shalom, Nathan. Did you watch it?
The crucifixion? No, I was fetching these volunteers.
You ought to be glad then. It was horrible. They whipped him without mercy. He was unrecognizable after. They stripped him naked and they hung him on that cross. They put him in the front of the city so everybody could walk by and mock him. I was waiting for him to do something, call down angels or fire. But he just let them kill him on that cursed cross. Why would he let them do that?
Why, Rufus? Why? But for our sakes, so that God might put our iniquities upon him.
That is nonsense. No man, no king conquers by his death. I thought he was the one. I'd seen so many people come, but they were all liars and thieves. But he did so many miracles. He took my lunch of 5 loaves and 2 fish and fed 5,000 men and all their families. He brought Lazarus back to life. He did so many miracles. He gave blind men their sight, so many healings. He spoke with anointing and confidence. He was the hope of all of Israel. But now he's gone!
Rufus, you speak of these miracles that you've seen. You say you believe, but you don't, because you don't believe his words. You've heard him. He told us he would be delivered to die. But Rufus, he would rise again in 3 days.
Don't be a fool, Nathan. No man can rise from the grave. I'm tired of believing in imaginary kingdoms and myths.
Oh, Rufus.
I'm done.
Rufus, please, don't speak this way.
I'm done. I have to leave.
Rufus, please. He doesn't understand. So many expected that Jesus as the Messiah would come, overthrow the Romans and reign on the throne of Judah, but it wasn't so. He didn't say that. He spoke that his kingdom was not of this earth. Oh, friends, I don't know what to do. Come, the tomb is just a little further. Peter,
what are you doing here? Who are they?
They were gonna volunteer for the burial.
Well, they're too late. They've already anointed and wrapped Jesus and placed him in the tomb, and Joseph was just here and rolled the stone in place.
Yes, we spoke to him earlier, but Peter, why are the Roman centurions guarding the tomb?
They're here because the priests went to Pilate and asked for a guard to be set and to watch the tomb for 3 days, day and night.
3 days? Peter, you know what this means? They fear that he will surely rise. This is amazing.
Even if Jesus rises from the dead, Nathan, what could I do to redeem myself for what I've done?
What do you mean, Peter? During the crucifixion, we all ran. I mean, there were soldiers everywhere. We had no choice. We all ran. But there's still forgiveness beyond that.
Nathan, you don't understand. We all ran, but I denied him. First to just a little servant girl, and then another, and then to a group of men cursing his name. I don't even know the man. All the while he's being mocked, beaten, scorned, shamefully spit upon. I can't even say anything or do anything when he needs me the most.
Oh, Peter, what are you saying? You've lost your faith? Do you not remember all these things? Peter, please, don't speak this way.
No, you remember what Jesus said? We were coming into Jerusalem and he was talking about being crucified, and I said, "No, not so, Lord, be it far from you." He said, "Get thou behind me, Satan." I think he's right. I don't know if I can serve God or...
No, Peter. What else is there? What else will you do?
I'll go fishing. I'll go back to my old life.
Fishing? You're gonna go back to fishing? After all the things that we saw, all the miracles, the things that he preached, this time we spent with the Savior of mankind, you're gonna deny that? And give it up for just one mistake? Peter, please, don't speak this way. Brother, you must believe.
You wouldn't understand, Nathan. I'm supposed to be Peter, the rock, the leader, the example. But I'm not that. And I can't be that anymore.
Peter, you can't go. Don't go back.
I'm sorry, Nathan.
Peter, please listen to me. Peter, listen! No. It wasn't supposed to be this way. It wasn't supposed to end like this. They're all leaving. I'm sorry, friends, but I must go. I've got to talk to them. I've got to convince them. He will rise again. I'm sorry, but I must leave you now. Goodbye, friends.
Did you see that? Oh my goodness, I can't wait to tell them. We gotta leave them. Jesus. Oh my gosh, I hope they're
Peter, Thomas, James!
Why would they answer?
Jesus, James, open the door this instant!
What is going on? Oh, hold on a moment. James, it's your mother.
Hello, Mother. You're visiting early in the morning. I hope all is well.
Only the most wonderful thing in the world has happened, and you would take forever to answer the door.
Brothers, what's all this racket? Oh, the women are here. That explains it.
Oh, hush, Thomas.
My mother has something she'd like to say. Go ahead, Mother.
Jesus, he's alive!
What?
You're crazy.
Oh, hold up. Speak slowly, Mother. What are you trying to say?
Oh, James, we went to the tomb this morning and the stone was rolled away.
But where were the guards?
Oh, nowhere to be found. And the body, Peter? It wasn't there. We went into the tomb, we checked, and Jesus wasn't there. He's alive!
I will look for myself.
Well, I'll say it was thieves. Besides, Peter's not going to find anything out of the ordinary. Because thieves stole the body. What for? I couldn't imagine.
Don't be silly, Thomas. We know he's alive because the angels told us so.
The angels?
Yes, there were two men in shiny garments. And they said, "Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but he has risen." Remember, he told us this would happen. He said that he would die, but on the third day he would rise again.
Nonsense. I don't believe it, and I won't believe it. And you better be careful about spreading false rumors around the city.
But it's true, Thomas.
Nonsense. Let me tell you, unless I see the nail prints in his hands and put my finger in them and put my hand in his side, I won't believe. Brother, I won't stand here and listen to these mad women any longer. You can if you want, but I'm hungry.
James, you believe us, don't you?
Mother, I want to. I really do. But I saw him die. I'm sorry. I just can't. Why don't you come in and refresh yourself?
Peace be unto you, friends. We are all going to sup later at the house of Cleopas, and you are more than welcome to join us. Cleopas provides lodging for weary travelers, so just follow the signs that say lodging ahead. Farewell.
Friends, you're here. Joanne told me you would make it. Won't you come with us to the courtyard?
Reverend, we're all here hiding for fear of our lives amongst our countrymen. What would the master have to say about this?
Well, as he isn't here or alive, for what matter, I couldn't say.
Hold your tongue. Did not Peter tell us of the empty tomb? Did not show us the linens that were left behind? Did not testify to seeing Jesus face to face?
Right. And at the seaside, he spoke to the fishermen. And the two on the road to Emmaus, he spoke to them. I can't believe for a moment that they were liars.
Well, he hasn't appeared to me. And you know what I say. Unless I see the nail prints in his hands.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Unless you see the nail prints and the wound in his side, you will not believe.
That's right. Besides, all I want is proof, and then I'll believe.
It's Jesus.
Thomas, come. My hands, behold. Put your finger in them. Put your hand in my side. Believe.
My Lord, my God.
Thomas, you believe because you have seen. But blessed are those who have not seen and yet still choose to believe.